The n8n team just dropped a hot new feature for building multi-agentic AI workflows. Let's check this one out. I'm looking here at a normal n8n AI agent. It's an analyst agent. It does some perplexity, search for the user, and outputs, let's say, a report for them, right? This is how I usually will build workflows. And if I wanted to do something multi-agentic, I would get the subworkflow tool, call another n8n workflow, and have something that looks kind of like this as a subworkflow. That works, and that's good for certain reasons, especially if that subworkflow is maybe not an AI workflow. Maybe it's just a traditional workflow. It's got AI steps. In either way, you have two separate entities. You got to go in two different places to work on those, which can be useful for separation concerns and certain production things. But the n8n team just added the AI agent tool itself. So you can now use another AI agent as a tool in the same workflow. So let's add that to my analyst agent and let's create a research agent that's going to be doing the research. And then we'll have the analyst agent as kind of the overseer. Why might I want to do this? Right now in my use case, I'm using Sonnet 4. Sonnet 4 is a relatively expensive model. What we're going to do for the research agent, the sub agent, which just has to take a query, use a tool, and then summarize that and send that back, is that's going to use a much cheaper model. We're going to use GPT 4.1 Nano, which is about 37 times cheaper than called Sonnet. So in this way, the analyst agent, the thinking brain, will have the power of that Sonnet foundation model and use that power in synthesizing the text output. Sonnet's really good at that. At the tool level, the thing that's going to be getting lots of tokens from the real world, from Perplexity, it's going to use a cheap model to parse that, chop that down before we send it to our expensive model. In tools, this is how you would get to the AI agent tool. You just search for it once you click on the plus here. But in classic cooking show style, here's one I made earlier. So let's add this in here. Let's disconnect Perplexity, attach my research agent. Let's attach the Perplexity tool to that research agent. Now, let's take a quick look inside the research agent. How this is going to look like, just like any tool, it's going to have a description. So call this research AI agent when you need a real-world research done. And then it has the user prompt, like you would in any AI agent. And this is where I'm going to use from AI. I could also just hit this button. This is the search queries populating. This is what my parent AI agent sees as the form it needs to fill to run this tool, to run this agent as a tool. This is all set up. So let's open the chat. Output. And analysis n8n, our favorite workflow automation tool. So we see the analyst starts and it decides to use a research agent and it's searching in Perplexity. While this runs, when I ran this with the analyst agent on its own and then the multi-agentic approach, the amount of tokens consumed, this is going to do 4, 5, 6 researches. It was about 50,000 tokens both times. It was a couple hundred tokens different. In this setup, about half or more of those tokens happen in here, in the model that's 37 times cheaper than that. So all those tokens it's ingesting or outputting happening with a cheaper model, and then we can use the right model for the right job. This is a simple example. You could extrapolate this out, obviously having multi-agentic nested tools, right? There's no reason that this agent couldn't call another AI agent. The n8n team has tested this multiple layers deep, and there's no degradation so far, so feel free to test that out and let us know. But you can theoretically use what I'm showing you here to go multiple levels deep, really separate concerns, and have the right agent for the right job so it's not getting confused. And I think one great example of this is for research or anywhere where you need to get a lot of tokens from the world, have your specific cheaper model process that, get the roll-up, the summary of what the parent agent needs to basically inform its next step. And then it's going to be more efficient this way. We can see in the logs, the way this is populating, we see we've got the parent agent and then the sub-agent tools that ran, and then the steps inside those as well. So we can see here we populated that Perplexity search tool. Here we did that again. It's getting a roll-up back. This is what the parent AI agent is getting back as a tool, which is different perhaps from the raw inputs that we're getting from Perplexity, right? Because this is that nano model summarizing that up. Here is a good highlight. Let's say in the single agent model, it will do the same number of calls. And that's relatively true when I was testing this. We already have 5 calls to the Sonnet model, and we have 9 calls to the 37 times cheaper GPT 4.1 model. So cost is one reason, but I would say the main reason, it lets you pick the right model for the right job. A lot of people say, you know, for creative writing, for outputting, synthesizing text, Sonnet is great. The Gemini models can be good for a certain tool calling and stuff. That's maybe another good use case here is tool calling. There's some really small open source models that are great at specifically calling tools. If you have some complicated tools that need big JSON objects specified in their parameters, maybe you're going to have an agent just for calling those tools. Okay, so this ran. Let's just have a look at this output here. It outputted an analysis of n8n. It says we're Swiss based in Lucerne. All right, so it's hallucinating quite a bit there. So that's something where now perhaps at the research agent level, at the Perplexity level, I might want to add some prompting, some checks around that, but I can do that focused just on the research agent. This is multi-agentic workflows natively in n8n powered by the AI agent tool itself. And I think We at the n8n team, we're all really excited to see the use cases that you're going to use this for, because this just came out. It's brand new. So I think a lot of the best practices around when to use this, when to use some workflows are still evolving. A very exciting time to be building with AI these days. I hope you found this little video helpful, and happy flowgramming. Keep it.